Welcome to Beacon High School online video. Today we are going to learn about the skeletal system.
An umbrella has a framework made of steel. If we remove the framework of the steel, then would umbrella retain its shape? No, it will not retain its shape. And the cage has a framework made of metal, and these framework protect the birds or animals present inside the cage. Building has a framework made of cement, iron and bricks. So these cement, iron and bricks give strength and support to the building. It provides proper structure to the building. Thus, a framework is a structure that provides strength and support. It gives definite shape to the object or a thing, and it protects anything that is present inside that structure. Can you feel something hard below the skin? Yes, these hard things are the bones. There is a framework of bones inside our body. This is called the skeleton. Thus, skeleton is a framework of bones inside our body. Skeleton gives shape and support to our body. Our body would be soft and shapeless if we do not have framework of bones for support. The skeleton also protects the soft, delicate inner organs such as the heart and lungs. It also enables movement of the body. There are different parts of skeleton system: skull, rib cage, backbone, limbs and girdles. Let's study about bones. You know, a human adult has 206 bones, whereas a human child has more than 350 bones. As the child grows, some of the bones fuse together and they form 206 bones when they become adult. Bones differ in size and shape. The bones of your fingers and toes are small, but the bones of your arms and legs are long. Bones are hard from outside but soft inside. Bones contain bone marrow. Now, what is bone marrow? Bone marrow is actually a soft and spongy substance present inside the bone. Minerals like calcium and phosphorus and certain vitamins are also present in bone. The study of bones is known as osteology. Human skeleton has different parts. Let us study about them. The first part is skull. The skull is a bony structure in our body that protects the brain. In adult human being, the skull is normally made up of 22 bones. They are joined together to cover the brain and to give shape to the head. All the bones in the skull are fixed except our lower jaw, which is movable. It is not fixed, which enable us to talk and eat. But remember, teeth are not bones. The skull is attached to the backbone at its base. The backbone is not made up of single long bone. It is a rod-like structure. It consists of series of 33 small bones. These 33 small bones are irregular ring-like bones and they are called vertebrae. These 33 bones or vertebrae join together to make up the vertebral column or spine. A flexible rod called the spinal cord passes through these rings. Thus, the vertebral column protects the spinal cord. Since the backbone is made up of many small bones, we are able to bend and twist the backbone in different direction. Between the vertebrae in the spine are rings of material called cartilage. Cartilage prevent the bones from rubbing against each other and damaging themselves. Cartilage act as a cushion between the vertebrae. There is a cartilage in your ears and nose too. Rib cage is a cage like structure and it protects the important organs present inside. Ribs are set of 12 pairs of long curved bones which surround the chest in the form of cage. A long bone at the center of the chest called sternum holds the ribs in the place in the front. The ribs are also attached to the backbone. The ribs cage protects the heart and the lungs. However, the last two pairs of ribs are not attached to the sternum and are attached to your backbone only. They are called floating ribs. There are two pairs of limbs, arms and legs. Limbs are made of long bones. Our arms are known as upper limbs and the legs are known as lower limbs. The upper arm and the lower arm together make the upper limbs. Humerus is the long bone in our upper arm. And the upper arm is joined to the spine with the help of the shoulder bones or the shoulder girdle. The upper leg and the lower leg together form the lower limbs. Femur is the thigh bone. There are many small bones in our hand, wrist and ankle. Femur is the longest bone in the body. Femur is attached to the hip bones or the hip girdle. A joint is the place in the body where two bones meet. Joints in the body allows easy movement. These joints are of two types, immovable and movable. Immovable joints are those which we cannot move, and movable joints are those which can be moved. Since bones of the skull are fixed and the joints between them are immovable, joints in other parts of the body are movable and are of four types: ball and socket joint, hinge joint, gliding joint, pivot joint. Let's study about the types of joint. First is the ball and socket joint. They are the most movable joints of the body and are called ball and socket joints. You can move these joints round and round. In this kind of joints, one end of a bone is like a ball and which fits into a socket of the other bone. The shoulder joint and hip joint are the best example of the ball and socket joint. Hinge joint. Such joints are present in the knees, elbows, fingers and toes. Hinge joint is like the hinges in a door. It enables movement similar to the opening and closing of the hinge door. Gliding joint. Bend your foot at the ankle. You can move it in two ways as shown in the picture, up and down and side to side. This type of joint, which allows the bones to slide over each other, is called the gliding joint. This type of joint is found in the bones of wrist and ankle. Pivot joint allows rotating. Move your head from side to side, move it up and down. Such a joint that allows nodding and shaking of the head is called pivot joint. The skull is connected to the backbone with a pivot joint. You now know that the joints allow us to move our body in different ways. But for movement to happen, the bones must be connected to muscles. Now, what are muscles? Muscles are fibrous structures made of proteins. We have over 600 muscles in the body. They are under the skin and surround the bones, organs, or other body parts. There are tough white fibers which attach muscles to bones. These are called tendons. So, what are tendons? Tendons are strong white fibers that attach muscles to the bones. Now, next is the ligament. Bones at the joints are held together by ligaments. Ligaments are like rubber bands. Thus, ligaments connect bone to the other bones to form joints. There are three kinds of muscles: voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles, and cardiac muscles. Voluntary or skeletal muscles are attached to our skeleton and are under our control. These muscles are found in the arms, legs, eyes. For example, if you wish to lift your school bag, you can do that. Involuntary muscles or smooth muscles are not under our control. They work automatically. They are found in our stomach, intestine. For example, respiration, circulation, and digestion. Cardiac or heart muscles are found in the heart. They are involuntary and work throughout our life without stopping or getting tired. Now, we should care our bones and muscles. We should eat healthy foods. We should go out in the open because sunlight is the source of vitamin D and which helps to make our bones strong. We should do regular exercise for the proper development of the muscles.